do believe that.
Yeah.
They don't want very sad that the Prime Minister of Israel has to make the comment and say, even if we have no friends and no allies, we're still going to do this. That's pathetic. Not his statement, but the fact that the U.S. has no backbone. Now, thankfully, there is still support from other parts of government.
I was about to ask you about the...
Yeah, we are still seeing support. So when I was in Washington, D.C., we walked through. So all of the representatives, there's 435 representatives. And they, when you look at their office buildings, there's three office buildings total. But we walked through the office buildings, and I was encouraged to see outside of the representatives' offices were Israeli flags and signs saying, we stand with Israel. And now these were Republicans and Democrats, and they had that on display. So I was very encouraged to see that there was a lot. In fact, I don't recall seeing one Palestinian flag on display.
How does the president take his staff, if you can call them that, is in favor of Israel and thank God for that? He's not.
Let's start it. It's widely known now, and it's being reported on very many conservative agencies. Joe Biden is kowtowing to his donors. Some of his biggest donors are those that are financing these pro-Hamas protests all over America. The Times Organization, George Soros Organization, Bill Gates, a lot of these organizations are funding these Palestinian support groups, the pro-Hamas groups, and anti-Israel protests. So he is kowtowing to them because he's going to lose his financing and pay if he doesn't, is what it appears to be. It's all about the money. It's all about the power. There's a severe corruption. That same thing happened during World War II when the IBM organization, preceding its name IBM, under Thomas Watson, bought the Holler machines and helped and assisted Adolf Hitler, and even was given awards by Adolf Hitler for his help to create a census that would track all the Jews throughout Europe. Ford helped Adolf Hitler by giving him the vehicles he needed, which ultimately were used in Poland. There's a strong hatred of Jews by many individuals in this country, or at least there's not that supported Hitler more than caring about the care of the Jews that supplied help to Germany.
Well, John, why do they hate Israel? Israel's not done anything to them.
Because they believe the lies about Israel. What is floating around everywhere is how evil of an occupier Israel is. All the cultural Marxists and all of our colleges and universities in the Ivy League area teach cultural Marxism. They're Marxists. They're moving towards communists. That's what these kids learn. So they feel any oppressed people need to fight against the oppressors. So Israel has been coined an oppressive people, an illegal possessor of land. So the cultural Marxists have jumped in alongside those that are considered to be anti-Israel that are on these Islamic elements. So you have them collaborating and working together. This is what has infested and infiltrated our universities, and sadly, it has affected some Christian colleges too.
What Luke tells us, you will be hated of all nations for my name's sake. So until the Son of God removes his name from Israel, he's not going to get it is a spiritual battle that we're witnessing.
It's a former student that was at my previous college. He has recently, on social media, decided to announce that he's now homosexual and be proud of that. But it's interesting in reading his stuff that a former Pentecostal conservative young man, now he's embraced this lifestyle. So everything that he is pushing now is pro-Palestine. I want to say, when you decided that you were not homosexual, did they send you something in the mail that says, okay, now you are pro-abortion, now you are you're anti-Israel, now you're pro-Black Lives Matter? It's like a package deal.
You're right.
Where you have all of these things, and it's instant, resistance. It's like, all of a sudden, okay, well, it's got to be spiritual. It's definitely spiritual, and it makes zero sense on these college campuses to have LGBTQ groups that are pro would be doing this, but it's very sad.
It's not a secluded case.
No, and it's not. That's the thing, is it's becoming more common than what
opposition it is.
It goes right along with it, along with Black Lives Matter, along with being pro-abortion, along with, you know, all of it's just amazing to me that you've got to check off this list of all of these things. And it's like, wow. I mean, you talk about not thinking for yourself or learning how to critical think, but just being fed things and spitting that back out. I mean, there is no logic to it. There is no, there's no critical thinking there. It's definitely demonic
deception. Exactly. That scripture tells us if they don't hold the truth and righteousness, that God would send the lie, that they would believe it. And they are so deceived, they're unable, some of them, to even see the truth in itself. Now, Israel is doing everything he can. Even Benjamin Netanyahu now placed on the internet his plan for the future of the Gaza. So he has a plan for them. It's a three-part plan. I don't believe it too much. But in that, he's talking about the next 12 months will be dealing with more humanitarian aid. Then for the next 10 years, he's looking at having Israel be the security force in the Gaza. They're bringing in a multi-Arab authority to help rule and govern the people with the intent that after 10 years, the year 2035, they will have self-rule. So he's talking about a three-stage plan. At least I'm encouraged to see that Israel will be the security force in place, a demilitarized Palestinian area. But then he's bringing in, I know this is all political, but he's bringing in the very Arab nations that Israel once fought against in the past. And maybe through the Abraham Accords, they think they're going to have some fellowship with these people or relationship with them, maybe on the basis of trade. But they're only getting closer to the ultimate escalation of this.
So he's really the security force he's going to allow to remain in Arab lands.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Yeah, I think he would get significant world pushback. Again, remember, Israel keeps trying to get themselves recognized as a nation. Unfortunately, for now, they're all concluding that Hamas needs to go. A lot of these Arab nations don't care for Hamas. Mm-hmm. Egypt actually outlawed them. The very place that the Muslim Brotherhood was founded and Hamas was founded was Egypt. Their leaders have all been pushed out. The last one
is Jews.
Well, the challenge is, you're right, Brother Schreier. The ideology that they follow isn't politically correct. They destroy everywhere they go. Everywhere they go, they're revolutionary. Whereas
why Egypt closed the border. Still kill and destroy.
Now they're following the devil. Exactly. That's why Egypt closed the border. That's why many of these other countries are accepting or warning everyone if it's at it. I hate to say this, but Hamas, yes, but we have to be fair and expand that definition to some degree to the Palestinian people as a whole. They are not capable of quote unquote self-governance. It's just absolutely ridiculous.
90% of Palestinians approve of what Hamas did and still approve of what they've done.
Yeah. So they're supporting
them.
So
for him to break down a part of Israel is
again, he's talking about a demilitarized area that Israel will have security power, but he's bringing in these other Arab nations, which through Abraham Accords, I believe, have been a little bit more willing to side with Israel because they all have a mutual enemy that's called Iran. So for now, they will enter into a truce. We've talked about this before. It's a strategy of Muhammad and Islam. And they will enter into a truce, a Huda, with the intent to break it later. This is building us towards what I believe to be more started. The accord and the agreement that the Antichrist will.
No, we're still building this coup.
It's still in process, from what I understand. Yes, the humanitarian aid plays a big part in the initial development of what is going on.
And who's going to rebuild Gaza now?
The world and the U.S. Our tax dollars, without a doubt.
We are. I'm pointing to you, said U.S. is going to rebuild it. Well, you're looking at us. That's how it goes.
If our military
contributes some probably to it, but as with everything else in the world, the United States carries and pays for the biggest part of the bill. We have a huge national debt to show for it. We have needs here in this country that are foregone, and we would be foolish enough to do that. Israel could easily, in my opinion, rebuild and take care of that area if it was Israel. But as long as it remains a separate, quote-unquote, state, it's a disaster. But it's not just who's going to rebuild what's above ground, but who's going to rebuild what's underground.
We look at the picture that was placed on the site that online. You see a modern city with modern buildings and shipping on the waters right next to it, indicating this.
this could be a beautiful and prosperous future for the Palestinian people. But sadly, we know from the Bible that's not going to be the case.
Well, America, what they need is just sin. Billions of dollars would take me to that.
So I am concerned about this, though. Our nation, I believe, is under watch by the Lord for how we treat Israel. And we're seeing more and more come against Israel. Benjamin also, that speech he made yesterday, given for Remembrance Day, said, as they said in Masada, never again. Meaning they will not sit down and commit suicide or allow themselves to be destroyed. They're going to stand in this. They may end up standing on. But we know that God is with them, in spite of the shortcomings that Israel may have had over its years. They are doing their best to stand out in a world that does not like them. And what this October 7th event did is it brought all the cockroaches out into the light. So we can now see internationally how much hatred there is against the Jews. Prior to that, it was there, but now it's been revealed. In this country, our support of Israel is waning. And if it continues on, as if the Lord should tarry, and our generations pass, that some of the older ones of us sitting here, this next generation, the one after,
well, it's waning. It's waning because the support from the church is waning.
I agree. I think that's a sad situation. How many churches have taught what we have done in the last few months since October 7th? And we've done it many times on various programs about Israel. I compliment you and your wife and Tommy always bringing up things of Israel. But I've watched television, and there's a few, but not many. And how many churches around this country really are sharing what's going on with Israel?
A lot of churches on Sunday mornings, for example, thank God they do this. They will say, pray for Israel. Let's remember Israel. You ask about teaching. I don't think that there's much more. I don't especially think that those that have immediate life, which is not happening. And I can say that because we're not seeing the nation change its direction. When the church gets it right, it doesn't just stay in the walls of the church. When the right teaching is going forth on the pulpit on Sunday morning, it has an impact Monday through Saturday.
Yeah.
Or you want to say. But that's how we can know, ladies and gentlemen, because when the church gets it right, it's preaching what's right. And we'll go back to it. In the church, we just preach the cross. Every aspect will be addressed. And that even includes getting elements of Bible prophecy and current events accurate. It's just that's the truth. But let me say this. Going through the Holocaust Memorial Museum, I was reminded. That's an incredible experience. That is a they both were fantastic. I've been to some other ones as well. But the ones in Washington, D.C. and in Jerusalem were incredible. But I was reminded, and it was made real to me, what took place leading up to the actual Holocaust and the sentiment that existed in Germany and throughout the world. The great war in Germany was all throughout Europe. And that exact same sentiment, I mean, Brother Sparkin, I felt like I was looking at headlines and current events, but it was from the 1930s. But I felt like I was looking at what was happening today.
Right.
Looking at the sentiment of the world, looking at the ship in St. Louis that came with so many Jews, thousands of Jews, that they were coming to Cuba. Cuba turned them away. And the United States said no. It was said that the Jews on that ship, they could see.
Yeah, let me take your baby.
They could see the piers, the docks, they could see the land of the United States on the southern tip of Florida, as they were very close to the country of Cuba. They were that close to freedom. They were that close to life. But Roosevelt said that ship was sent back. And every single one of those people ended up in a concentration camp.
Right.
So when I look at that, and I look at what's happening,
because President Roosevelt did not want to upset Tucker Carlson.
Yeah, well, President Roosevelt was acting like a cop, and then just happened to be the president right now. But yeah, there were reasons, and I know at the time when things went wrong, and did with that. But the fact is, if the United States would have opened up the door to the Jewish people,
well, that's making me sick.
government.
To unify under the truth, the banner of the truth, what's happening is we have bought the lie that moral issues
are moral issues,
and the church should stay out of them. When the church's influence is when the church and its influence stays away from politics, quote unquote, these moral issues, there's no light to guide the nation.
Right.
The very thing that Satan wants is for the church to stay away. It's for the Christian to butt out of it. And what's happening to the modern pastor, preacher, he's fallen under this pressure, really it's just deception. But we've got to realize that the identity of America is at stake. We won't stand as a nation if we... And what's happened? You called this out in a message, Brother Swigert, in the 80s. The movement of the I believe it's the Equal Rights Amendments. The feminist movement, it began back in the 80s. What we've been seeing, I just bring out something that Dave said. What are the women's rights under Hezbollah? What are the women's rights under Hamas? And then question, what are they in Israel? They're a free nation.
Yeah.
And the hilarious thing about what's going on is it's deception. It's a fool's game. It really is. But you said this in the 80s. We have embraced a humanistic education in this nation. And you said this, and it's striking, but you said if tomorrow the public school system went bankrupt in this nation, it would be the best thing that ever happened to America.
Yeah.
Because we have been raising our children and the next generation on a secularist education. And what are the results of that secularist education? Poverty, inflation, suicide, drug addiction, homosexuality, transgenderism. This is what America is touting as our core foundation. And we've rejected the Bible, said get it out of our schools, and we wonder why we're in the condition we are in today. And the sad reality is we are in an identity crisis as a nation. Because what once made us great, it is the scriptures, it is the word of God. We today, we are a nation divided.
Brother Parker, what I think you're referring to, Rape of the Nation, how prophetic it was written in 1980s. A double-minded man is unstable.
Yes. I was surprised that it's been about 6 months ago now. But I take back at the man's name. He's been on the staff at President Trump. And he's Jewish. He's a brilliant individual. But he held up that book. You need to read this. we're going to start now.
Let me tell you this real quick. When we were there in Washington, we stopped to the office of Congressman Clay Higgins. He represents the District of Louisiana.
Yes.
He was on Francis and Friends a couple of times. And the Congressman was not there. He had come back home. But we walked in, his staff said, would you like to see his office? I said, sure. So we walked in, and they didn't know we'd be coming by or anything like that. And I looked over, and he has two chairs and a table in the middle, and that's where when he has guests come into his office, they sit there, they talk, and usually, you know, that's where they take pictures. And opened up on the table right between the chairs was the exposure stand by. And I showed John, I said, hey, do you recognize that? He goes, well, that's one of our Bibles. I said, exactly. So the expository study Bible was over right there. And I told the staff, I said, that's, you know what that is? And I explained it. Wow, no, I didn't realize what that was, but apparently the congressman reads it. So, and he had the signature edition over on his, for his bookstore as well. So I was extremely encouraged to see that he didn't just receive the expositors as a gift and put it away somewhere, but it was open on display there in his office.
If I had the address, I'd like to give all the members of Congress, or the House or the Senate, both a copy.
We can get that for you. We have that's easy.
All order.
That's how we can work on it. And
I'd like to do that.
Yeah, that would be something to do.
Yeah, you might. I'd like to.
survival. And I'm sure that the notes were keeping that interest alive.
Probably aren't, but it would be amazing to hand deliver some of these bottles of this 50% plus. Maybe I'll we'll try to take up that task. That would be great.
Just let me know and we'll start sending them.
All right.
Maybe yeah. We have some addresses. I'm going to start now and I'll study for today on spiritual warfare.
Perfect segue into it. Should we start it before or after the break?
We'll start after the break. We'll get on that.
Academically sound.
I'm
Those have to be repetitive. Psychology has to be repetitive.
that's going back for appearance.
And it's the only one work against him. It's the cross. So, that bad stuff there by some, but I honestly believe that just as impactful as the Protestant Reformation, the Protestant and the Azusa Street Revival and the Gang of I believe the message of the cross can make that kind of impact. I agree on the nation, the world, it can be another great move of God that is God's final message for the church to get back to the cross, to believe the finished work of Calvary for justification and for sanctification, and have the cross-centered church and the cross-centered community and a cross-centered nation. You know, that's the only thing that will save our nation. So I 100% believe that it can be as impactful and as important as these other times when God has come on the scene. In the past, with the first and second great awakening, with the Reformation, with the early Pentecostal movement, the beginning of Pentecost in the 20th century. So, I do think it's God's message for the church and for the world.
Well, the message of the church, your family worship center is almost bigger than you think. It really is. I don't think people see the scope of the size of the world. This is the culmination of what began in the Reformation. We are the beginning of the Reformation. Now we have the message that's going to bring the culmination together. It puts every other pieces of it together and brings it to its proper understanding, its proper foundation, and how to build upon it. When the Reformation didn't have some of those elements, but we have all that light that gradually was being revealed by the Lord through the Azusa Street, through the missionary outreach that took place in the 20th century. And now we have that coming together, this whole movement that the Lord has brought coming to the people now.
Speaking that word to us today,
yes,
exactly.
years he did 3,000 years ago, 3,500 years ago. Like I said a moment ago, the cross of Christ is the cement that holds this covenant together. And by the grace of God, we're going to see creatures of the thousands take it in heaven.
Yes. Why did he say,
preaching the cross?
Why did he add that note? Be not afraid. Some are fearful of this cross, right? Anxiety, fear. But he said, the Lord thy God is with thee. He's with you today.
Those who step out are going to see God in moments I've never seen in him before. Praise God. We're going out of time, ladies and gentlemen.
No, sir.
So what I want to close the program. Thank you for being with us. Don't miss the next program. God bless you.
God bless you, sir.
Thank you for joining us on today's Broken Cross Watch Program.
Think I'm doing evil, then wipe his ass. I'm doing evil.
If you enjoy the music, if you enjoy the teaching, if you enjoy the preaching, if you
That was a good one for Who Believes in
Me. Oh, too bad.